Welcome, 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 collective. Welcome back to my channel. This is Queen here, back here again with another general intuitive message for the collective. Gonna untap right in, check the energy here. Remember to take what resonates and to leave what does not. Somebody avoided a tower here, okay? Somebody avoided some type of disruption here. Remember that energy is fluid. We could be picking up on masculine or feminine energy, so reverse the roles when necessary. Also, time is fluid. We could be picking up on past, present, or future events here. Hang on a second. All right, with that in mind, let's tap right on in. Yeah, somebody avoided some type of tower here. Somebody tried to have somebody distracted. It's the energy I'm getting here. Yeah, I'm hearing it's a tall order. That was a tall order. Yeah. Maybe you lost a little sleep over this, or didn't lose much sleep at all. I don't know. Yeah, somebody thought you walk into something blindly walk into something here. And now they're trying to explain themselves like it was just a misunderstanding here. What's here, Holy Spirit? Please and thank you. What do they need to know? What do they need to know? Okay. Let's see here. We have the Five of Pentacles, the Knight of Wands. I'm not doing any reverses. And we have the Ace of Pentacles. Oh, I see what this is. Somebody came in and got in a relationship with somebody, and they had options already. They were dealing with more than one person, okay? They pretended to walk into this person's life, like they wanted to have some type of relationship, and something happened where this person they got with got ill, okay? They contracted something from this person here. Some type of STD. Now somebody wants them to think it was just a misunderstanding here. Okay. Like, well, I thought, you know, I didn't get it from you, but, you know, I thought I got it from you. Thank you, Spirit. I thought I got it from you. All right. The Eight of Swords. Here. Yeah. Somebody was saying, I thought I got it with you when I slept with you, but this person had already slept with several others. So they don't know where it came from, is what I'm getting here. They don't know where this STD came from. Wow. But they got with somebody, and this person ended up catching it. This new person they got with ended up catching this STD. Because the person they were dealing with, we're dealing with several other people here. Okay? At least three or four more. At least four other people they were dealing with. And somebody ended up at the hospital. Okay, getting checked out here. Okay. Well, I'm hearing several people may know about this too. Here. Okay. Several people may know about this. Wow, it's no secret for sure. It's no secret. Several people know about it with the Ten of Pentacles in reverse. There's several people that know about this. Because this person was dealing with several people. Several other people. And they end up passing along an STD to this person. They ended up at the hospital. What else is here? And they want to try and tell this person that, no, it was a misunderstanding, you know. But they knew that they were dealing with more than them. You know, more than just this person here. All right. Wow. Told you everybody, you know, there's some people know. There's a group of people that know what's going on here. Okay, this is the Queen of Pentacles here. You're just sitting here minding your business. Somebody comes along, take interest in you, or whatever. Seeing that you're, you know, stable, well-loved, beautiful, kind. I mean, really stable here. And maybe somebody sent this person your way just to see what would happen is what I'm getting here. Just to see if they could trick you or put you in some type of illusion here to make you believe that they wanted you. Just to get at your money, to get at your finances, to, you know, maybe, you know, like they seen you were stable and you were, you know, somebody that was beautiful or something like that here. And they end up bringing a package along with them, but it was the one that sent you to the hospital. Wow. Now you need some help here with the Five of Cups here because you can't cope with whatever this is here. This person is asking for your forgiveness or whatever they did, because they were definitely burning downstairs. They were definitely burning. Okay. Now they want to apologize to you because you never did anything to them. Here, they were just a liar about how many people they were dealing with here. Ace of Swords. They were just lying to you here. Okay. Wow. This person is very selfish. Okay. But they have like a hyper sex drive. They have a hyper sex drive here. I mean, it's almost like they need that, maybe. I almost said they take some kind of drug enhancement drug or something. Hang on, collector. Some type of enhancement drug. Okay. That's the energy I'm getting here. But like I said, they didn't want to come clean here. All right. They didn't want to come clean. Maybe there was some type of argument between two people behind this. Okay. Two or more people. I'm getting at least three. Okay. There was an argument as to who gave what to who. All right. Somebody's wishing they never got into this relationship here. Or this situationship. Somebody's wishing they never got into it here. What else is here, Spirit? Yeah, somebody wanted somebody to think that it was just a misunderstanding, but that didn't stop the rumor from spreading around that somebody had an STD here. Okay. Wow. What's here, Spirit? What do they need to know? What do they need to know? Yeah, somebody thought they could, you know, like, reel somebody in with money or something, like, because they had money, they could get away and have all these sexual partners and stuff, and have this person end up having to go to the hospital because they liked sleeping around. This other person they were dealing with liked sleeping around. Okay. Wow. I'm hearing it wasn't worth it. It wasn't worth it. It could never be worth it. Not when it comes to my health. Not when I have to sit in a damn hospital. You know, because this person wanted to choose to mess around here. Yeah, that was a tall order is what I'm hearing. Yeah, you remove yourself from this person here. You know that it was definitely a mistake to even deal with this person now. Okay, this person wasn't going to be right. Okay, you wish you could take it all back. Maybe you kept yourself writing letters to this person. You ball them up and throw them in the trash. Like, you know, like, how did I ever get caught up with somebody like you? For you to do me this way. Alright. For some of y'all, it was an STD. For some of y'all, was just catching this person cheating. Okay. What else? Finding out that this person has several partners. Okay. And they thought that they could wine and dine you or, you know, pull you in with money or something like that. And that you would go for, you know, their bullshit. No, not alone, they were burned downstairs. Wow. Be it masculine or feminine, they asses was burning. Okay. Wow. What else is here, Spirit? Yeah, this person sleeps around. They at least was sleeping with four different people when they were messing around with somebody else here. When they were dealing with somebody else in a commitment. Yeah, you want this person to move on. You want to start over here. You want to start over. You want to right the wrongs, the mistakes that you made by dealing with this person. All right. Well, you could be a business person. You can work in an office. Okay, you're definitely detaching from this person. Okay, you need to just free your mind. Like, I mean, it wasn't your fault, you know. You just need to clear your mind. Maybe that's why you write down a lot of stuff here. Okay. So look over it. Think about, maybe that's the way you escape the thought of what this person did to you. It's by writing it down. Maybe writing letters to yourself. Maybe writing letters to this person. In some way to help try to heal your heart. Okay. You keep reminding yourself how much you love yourself here. Okay. You know, healing yourself, you know. Wow. From the mistakes that you made in your life and allowing yourself to be entangled with such a negative person here that would do something like this here. Okay. What else is here? What else is here, spirit? Yeah, you're trying to heal. All right. From even being connected with this person here. Well, you're doing a lot of thinking. You're trying to move on, get past this, okay? You don't understand why this person would do something like this to you or even put you in this type of position here. All right. Maybe they did it out of habit, you're thinking. I don't know. Maybe this is something that you're thinking this person has been doing all along. I mean, like, they're so carefree about it. Like, it make you wonder, right? Well, you want to gain some clarity about why you. Why you. You want something revealed here. Like, why you? Why didn't this person just tell you the truth in the first place here? Before they caused all this damage, okay? They could have just told you the truth, okay? Wow. Now you're stressed out. Because this person, you know, kept these secrets, okay? You thought this was somebody that, you know, you thought this person was like your dream come true. Now you find yourself trying to, you know, heal from the heartbreak this person caused you here by keeping this secret about, you know, them having several options here, okay? Wow. You wish you had never got with this person. Yeah, you're confused. But Spirit said it wasn't your fault, okay, that this person wasn't clear to you about what they were doing. But yeah, with these secrets, now you're confused about what did this person want with you anyway? You know, why would they even come your way if they knew they had other options here? This person couldn't tell you the truth, all right? This person may have came in like they had some type of spiritual background or something like that. Spirit said they was all lies. They was just there to chase you. To chase you. All right, whoever you are, masculine or feminine, all right? Yeah, they was there to chase you. Now that they, you know, had somebody burnt here, they don't want to chase them anymore, okay? Once they sting somebody, they keep going. They move on to the next victim here. This is a narcissist for sure. All right, and they don't care who they hurt, who they walk over, whatever. They just don't care. They get people to fall for them, and then they do some stupid shit like this, like, you know, burn somebody or give somebody an STD, and they don't tell them that they have several partners, like they have some type of sexual addiction here. And they don't check people's, you know, doctor records to see if they have anything. I at least make this person go to the doctor to make sure they don't have anything before they engage in sex with them. Okay, a lot of people are making that a practice now. Like, you know, no, I need a full checkup on your ass, you know, before I even lay down with you. I don't care how fine you are. I don't care how sexy you are. I don't care how handsome you are. Before we get into this connection, listen, we gonna go to the doc and we gonna get you a full checkup. And, you know, you're going to see this other full checkup from me as well. This is what, you know, you're saying to this person, and we can move forward from there. Because you don't want somebody that's dipping in garbage cans out here to come, you know, in your heavenly portal. I don't think so. Or you know, park in a garage and shit is full of junk. Okay? Wow. You want to get away from these type of people. Okay, to try to keep you on third parties. Okay? You try to avoid situations like this, okay? Because you know, cause you to be in regret. And this is just what happened. I'm hearing this is just what happened. Wow. Just when you thought things were going to get better for you in your life, things got even harder. You found out this person was, you know, had you in a third party, or had you, and they had several other options. Okay, now you're sitting in regret, wishing it never happened here. Wow. And now people are talking about it, because yeah, they're looking at you. And I heard the rumors about you, that you dealt with so-and-so, and so-and-so was burning. Well, maybe you're saying it's just a misunderstanding. I don't know. Wow, you know you're a better person than that person was to you. You were a better person to them than they were to you when it comes to this commitment. Okay, but you definitely didn't expect this outcome. All right? Nothing like this. You never expected this shit. This shit got you overwhelmed. It got you overwhelmed. This person just can't tell you it's just a misunderstanding. You want this person to be held responsible for what they did here. Responsible for the actions they take. All right? Shit. You want to talk about it. You want to give this person a piece of your mind here. Okay? Because of what they did to you. They're guilty. They caused you some pain. They caused you some type of damage here. You want them to feel this, what they did to you. Okay? And until then, you ain't going to be satisfied until you give this person a piece of your mind, whoever you are. Yeah. This person might want to tell you it's just a misunderstanding. See, I got this sex addiction that I just can't, you know, stop it. But I know that me and you are meant to be together. You're like, bullshit. You're not going to feed me that shit, okay? I'm not a daydreamer, all right? That's what you're telling these people. Mm-hmm. You might have stopped speaking to this person. Or are you going to stop speaking to this person if you haven't found out that they did this, okay? Wow. This person is... It's like telling you that, no, we're meant to be. It's just a misunderstanding. Oh, this is a pass. Let's go to the doctor and get a shot or something. Whatever the fuck they do, you know. Yeah. And you're like, no, you caused too much damage. Like, this is painful. You ready to just let this all go, but not before you get this person a piece of your mind here. Yeah. You're saying it's not worth it. It's not worth it dealing with this person. What's their spirit? You're trying not to be angry, but you are. And it's not a laughing matter. But I'm just saying, this person should have told you. They should have confessed to you. And now it's a rumor going around about it, and they want to tell you this is a misunderstanding. And you're like, shit, it wasn't even worth fooling with this person. Why did I fool with this person here? Okay? Yeah. But it could have been about money. Yeah. This person talked a lot of shit about, you know, them having money and so forth, and... Well, knowing that they were going to, you know, play somebody as a fling or something here in the first place. Because they had several options, okay? Wow. What else is here? Maybe you kind of told this person you had to go to the hospital or whatever, get checked out, something wasn't right, something didn't feel right, you know. Something was heated downstairs, you know what I'm saying? And this person was like, well, okay, well, I'll come where you're at, like... And they were trying to tell you, like, it was a misunderstanding. Maybe I didn't know that I had this thing, you know, and I never meant to pass it on to you. But this person knew exactly what they were doing, Spirit said here. They knew exactly what they were doing because they were messing with at least four other people. This person has a sexual addiction that they've been hiding here. Right. Yeah, I avoid mentioning making plans here. Yeah, because they can't tell you what they're doing. Wow, they can't tell you what they've been doing or what they be up to. They'll be like, well, you know, it's so complicated. I don't know. I didn't tell you that I was still messing with so-and-so, but I mean, listen, look, it was just a misunderstanding. But yeah, this person will never tell you what they're doing, what they up to, where they're going. Okay. But now there's rumors going around about somebody has an STD. And this person wanted to tell you it was all just a misunderstanding, a big mistake, okay? But, yeah, they never told you the full truth. That's what Spirit said. Now you're overwhelmed, okay? You got responsibilities. You ain't got time for dealing with persons with third parties and stuff like that. I mean, that's a complicated life for you. You're not trying to deal with it. And this person couldn't explain anything to you. Yeah, well, they could have. They chose not to. Yeah, shouldn't, shouldn't, shouldn't. Wow. This you maybe ask this person like, well, let's figure this out because whoever else you slept with probably, you know, need to go to the doctor too. He said, oh, no. She said, no, we shouldn't do that. We shouldn't do that. They don't want to make no plans on talking to these other people or not, because you would find out that they were actually talking to at least four more other people, and you want they maybe told you about one of them, but they didn't tell you about the other three. And like, no, we can just figure this out together. We can talk about it together. Yeah. They only said it because they never planned on anyone else seeing y'all two together or even talking about what transpired with this transference of this STD here. And if they if you bring it up to one the person that they tell you that they got it from, you would have to go see at least four people. Why? Imagine that spread there. Wow. What else is here? They couldn't do it. They couldn't do it because they would have to confess to mess with more than one person here. That's why they're avoiding it, okay? They want to tell you that's just a misunderstanding. And maybe you heard some things about it. They were messing with three or four people, or maybe, you know, at least one or two others outside of messing with you. And maybe, you know, somebody said, well, maybe they told you this person that gave you this STD said that, hey, you know, it's just a rumor. It's just a rumor. No, I never did that. I never did that. But yeah, they did. They just not gonna fess up. Yeah. This person you were dealing with also seemed distracted. Okay, like they were always like something wasn't enough. And this is what's giving you reason to doubt this person that they didn't know that they already had this STD when they came towards you here. Yeah, I hear it. They should be ashamed of themselves. That's what I hear you say. They should be ashamed of themselves. Wow, this is a whole ass grown adult here. Oh, somebody could be pregnant. Somebody could be pregnant. Wow. Wow. This is the love that somebody wish they had to let go. They wish they had to let this person go before all this shit got started here. Wow. Whoever you are, you know you have the power to drive, you know, evil spirits away. Whoever you are, you just wish that you had made this mistake with this person here. Because he or she was fake as hell. Wow. Seriously, none of this was, don't take this personal. None of this was ever about you. Okay, this person just has an addiction. Okay, and it's something they need to work on for themselves here. Yeah. Yeah, maybe you even caught this person with the third party. Or the fourth or the fifth. Take how it resonates. Yeah, I wanted to forget, but I couldn't. Yeah, maybe you saw this person standing with somebody else, and once you had to make that hospital visit or that doctor visit, and you found out what was going on with you, yeah, you couldn't forget it. You couldn't forget that reflecting back now that you think about it, you did see this other person, your person standing with this other person here. And you're disgusted with yourself now because you didn't say anything? Wow. So now somebody's pregnant here. You may live together, but you guys are not speaking. You may share the same space, but you're not sharing words here. Wow, you're not speaking. Somebody feels like they made a big mistake because their person has them in a third party. Or somebody's gotten somebody pregnant here. And they feel like it's a big mistake. But getting with this party, they had them in a third party. Some things do not need words. Wow. You're showing this person how disgusted you are. You're not even speaking to this person. Wow. You're so disgusted with this person, okay? Just some things you can't answer right now. You avoid mentioning making plans with this person, any future plans with this person, because you feel like you shouldn't. You feel like you shouldn't. especially when you reflect on seeing this person with somebody, you feel like then you should just let them go. Yeah, if somebody else wants this person, you just, you know, you want them to go ahead and be with them. Go be with them, okay? If she or he wants you, go be with them. If they want you, go be with them. That's what I hear you say. Wow. Is that the only one spirit? What else is here? What else is here? What else is here, spirit? And you're wondering if who else knows. If somebody else, you're wondering if they know too, because I'm telling you, this information got around. Yeah, they heard a rumor, and you're hoping that this rumor doesn't follow you, okay? Well, you're wondering if somebody else knows, or this person wonders if you know, if he or she knows that they gave it to you. You're wondering if you know. Yeah. Now this person wants to play victim like it was just a misunderstanding. How is it a misunderstanding? Okay. This could even be, like I said, I kept seeing like a stained glass window in the church. This could even be a church freak trying to get it on, going around passing out STDs with their nasty self. Okay. Somebody to try to, you know, somebody that pretended that they were spiritual. Okay. Wow. And that's for somebody here. Some old nasty church freak trying to get their freak on. Going around spreading STDs and stuff. Maybe, hell, everybody in the church know this person spreading STDs. Uh-huh. You know how church folks talk. You know, word goes around in the church, honey. About sister so-and-so, brother so-and-so, deacon so-and-so, you know. Yeah. The pastor slept with so-and-so. You know, word goes around in the church. There's more gossip in the church than it is a pastor in there, you know. That's the place you go to get the latest gossip. That's where the real news at in the church. Go to the church. You found out what Sally cooked for dinner. Who been visiting his or her house, they house. How many children they got, where they work at. You know, how much money they put in the offering and shit like that, you know. Wow, that's where you found all your gossip at. Yeah, you was too good for this person that you hooked up with. Whoever you are. Yeah, avoid making any more plans with this person. Yeah. Wow. Yeah, you're praying for a miracle. And maybe you all go to the same church. I mean, I don't know. For some of you, not for all of you. Yeah, you don't know what you did wrong to deserve this. You didn't do anything wrong. That's what Spirit said earlier. You didn't do anything wrong. Yeah. One more, Spirit, before I close out. You're going to get some relief from this, okay? But, yeah, it's messier than you thought it would be. It is. You wonder if others know, and they do. Okay. But once it's all out, said and done with, you heal from this and you move on, you're gonna feel some relief here. You're gonna get some relief. All right. Wow. Whoever did this to you has a face that doesn't apologize, and wow, you're disgusted with yourself. I'm just gonna keep it real, okay? Wow, you can't even speak to this person. You want to forget about what they did to you because some of you guys have healed, or some of you guys are healing. You know, you're moving forward, you know. But, wow, is this hard to figure this one out? Like, how did you get yourself in a situation? Okay, this kind of did break your heart, whoever you are, is what I'm getting here. You kind of fell in love with this person, or you thought it was love, you know. But, wow. You feel like this person didn't appreciate you or the time that you got with them, right? Maybe somebody came up to you and because things got messier than what you thought they would be, because, you know, maybe you had to stop somebody in their tracks and be like, why'd you bring that up? Okay, you're already disgusted with yourself for even dealing with a damn narcissist like this, okay? Yeah, but you're gonna deny it. And Spirit said it's okay to deny because it ain't nobody else's business. They can assume and think what they want. Okay, because when you assume, the first three letters is ass, they can make an ass out of themselves by assuming something because they don't know unless you tell them. All right? As long as you're not going around, you know what I'm saying? And I know you're not collected, but this person is not taking any safety precautions or any sexual protections here. So, yeah. When somebody confronts you with this, you know, you're going to probably say, hey, look, you must be out of your damn mind. I wouldn't mess with that person, you know, with somebody else's stuff. You know what I'm saying? Wow. You just want to escape the whole situation. You might end up leaving the area, or leaving that company of that person or wherever they may be at. Okay, just need to escape. Okay, but spirit says you went in silence, but not even answering to these people when they bring it up. Okay, because for some of you they do bring it up, they do ask. Okay, because they're probably, spirit said they asked them because they've been a victim too of the same person. That's why they asked them. Because they've been a victim in the past of the same person. Yeah. You feel. You said this love and distaste I feel for you. Just going to keep silent. Because boy. You don't even want nobody to know. That you were with this person. Wow. Because they got a lot going on. They got a lot going on. And you had that you even got mixed up in the mess. Okay. Wow. Well, I'm going to end it there. This person was definitely what you may have thought it was chemistry. Okay, well, but now you're trying to figure out what is other people talking about. What are they saying? But you're hoping for the best, okay? You're hoping for the best to be able to get through this. One more. Possible outcome. One more. What they need to know. You're going to get through this, whoever you are. Alright. But it's a question of how many people know. You know, how many people have been affected by this. Believe me, you're not the only one. The same people that are asking you questions about this person, the same ones that has been a victim of what this person has done to you, they have done to these other people too as well. Yeah. Well. Okay. What spirit said. This person, after some time, may think they can. Well, no, they know it's too late. They know it's too late to even get back with you. Too late to take any action. Or either they're afraid to take any action to come towards you. Okay? Wow, because of all the talk that's going on here. And they know that you wouldn't have it no way. You would definitely disagree. We're having this person come towards you because of their habits here. Their sexual habits here. All right. Wow. I told you, get this person a piece of your mind. You let them know how you truly feel. You don't even want this person to come to your house. You probably met them in a restaurant or something to give them the news about their little bad, nasty ass habits, okay? You don't even know if this person will ever change. You think that this person's messed up. What's this here? Yeah, you wouldn't think twice about getting back with this person because you feel like they did not appreciate you by putting you in a position like that. Yeah, you feel like this person didn't even care. Okay. Yeah, this person know they neglected your values here because they were in their ego here and couldn't show you what they were truly doing behind. Yeah, you're back here. Whoa, this weather change is something else here. Yeah, they sabotaged this whole thing here. Wow, with some freaking dishonesty. Just, you know, they could have just been honest, but they lied, and their lies just tried to rip you apart. They messed up a good thing. Wow. You're upset about it. You feel like this person didn't appreciate you. It's because of somebody you thought you fell in love with. Okay. For some of y'all, this person thought because you had children that and their daddy wasn't around that you know, you needed them or you needed some support, but they brought more than support, honey. They brought some STD around. Yeah. Wow. This person shocked you. Yeah, they did. You're getting away from this person as fast as you can. Okay. Yeah. You need some time to think. Because I want to know you. I'm hearing that you want to get this person a piece of your mind. And you ain't going to be satisfied until you do. Okay. And you really feel like this person ain't even worthy of you even speaking to them. Okay. But you're going to speak your mind about what they did. About their little dark side. Okay. Wow. You ain't going to hold back neither. But this person hurt you. Wow. This person neglected your self-worth here. Wow. They really mistook you or misunderstood you or misunderstood your situation and took it for something else, okay? I'm hearing you say, yeah, you better run. Motherfucker, you better run. Ooh, wee, you messed up. You better run. Oh, my God. Oh, wow. Yeah, but, yeah, this person has some bad habits, all right? This person has some very, very, very bad habits here. Wow. They have a lot going on. He or she has a lot going on. You have a distaste for this person now. One time you might have loved them in your own way, but this person has put a nasty taste in your mouth and you just want to say some nasty things to this person and about this person, but you don't even want nobody to know that you even mess with this person because this person has a history of doing this shit to people and everybody knows it. A lot of people around in that circle knows about what this person goes around doing and that they have a habit of not wearing protection and they catch STDs and they pass them to other people because they have a sexual addiction. They mess with more than one person. Okay. Wow. This person may have money. This person may come in like they want to help. This person may say the right words. Okay. You know, to get it, you know, on your good side or whatever. And then, have a nurse ask you, what? I don't know what I did wrong. Well, it's a misunderstanding. No, some of y'all, somebody's pregnant here. Somebody got pregnant here. Wow. Yeah, you're in deep thought. You're thinking this person must be out their damn mind to think that you're going to deal with them, even whether you're pregnant by them or not. That's how you end up finding out that you had an STD. Somebody went to the doctor and found out they was pregnant. Wow. Now this person, well, we can figure this out together. You say, no, you should have confessed this at first because now you put me in danger and my unborn child. You must be crazy. That's what I hear somebody say. Yeah. You're hearing all these rumors, okay? Spirit says you ain't gotta say nothing to nobody. All right. Especially if this is some people at church. All right. Then I'm picking up on. Yeah, you ain't got to say nothing. All right, whoever you was dealing with was just an actor trying to take center stage here. Okay. They love messing around with everybody. Wow, church whore. That's what I'm hearing, a church whore. Yeah. This is their excuse all the time. It was just a misunderstanding. That's their line. It was just a misunderstanding. But see, they don't understand the door they open up to this pain they caused you, this damage they have caused you here. For keeping this a secret or thinking they could keep you a secret or something like that here. You feel like it was a big mistake because this person, you know, did a lot of damage here in this commitment here. All right. Well, you regret trying to mend your heart. Okay. Want to escape the pain. This person has no idea. No idea. Yeah. How far you want to be away from them. Some of y'all just want to move on with your life. Not deal with this person because they're in a third party here. You want to start over. It's a new chapter here. You know this person getting with this person from masculine. Was a mistake here. Alright? And everything that came with this person was a mistake here. Well, this person will never own up to what they did to you. I don't care. This person, I mean, like, I don't know. Whew. They will never take responsibility. They will never take responsibility. And for some of y'all, the stress about them not taking responsibility for what they did to you is draining you. It's straining you. This is crazy. This was damn sure an unexpected outcome. You weren't looking for this. You feel like this person could have told you before they even thought about chasing you or coming towards you. All right, because they came towards you. You're like, yeah, you know what? I'm in love, all right, but I'm in love with myself. That's what I hear you say. This person could have told you they was burning downstairs. See, downstairs is burning. They could have told you they was burning downstairs. All right. You had to find out when you went to the hospital. Some of y'all, everybody ain't pregnant on here though. This is somebody that somebody hooked up with and, you know, has sex with and shit. Wow. Somebody went to go tell somebody to get some type of justice here in this situation here to try to figure something out. It was an argument going on. And there was some type of mediator in the middle of this too. All right. And you're putting an end to it with this person here. This person caused you nothing but nightmares here. And you're wondering if everybody knows, spirit says you don't have to answer to nobody. You don't owe nobody no explanation here. Okay? If they ask if you ever mess with this person, you can say, I mean, you don't have to say anything. Everything doesn't need words, spirit said. As long as you never say anything, you know, nobody can say that you said anything. Nobody can say you denied it or accepted it. Just leave them wondering, spirit said. Don't answer. You don't have to answer to anybody. You know, but the Most High God, you know. Wow. You just continue to heal. That's what spirit said. You continue to heal. Ace of Swords, that's the truth. Just continue to heal. Alright. Wow. And for those of y'all that's with child, the Two of Swords here. Yeah. It's gonna be a bundle of joy. Congratulations. Congratulations, okay? Wow. Yep, it's going to be a bundle of joy here. Even though it was like, you know, you may have to, I don't know, maybe sooner or later, like, on down the line, if you and this person are not speaking right now, you feel like it was a big mistake and you ended up with a child with this person, maybe on down the line, things may get better for you guys. You know, it may end up in the Ten of Cups, you know. I don't know. The spirit says, you know, just right now, just focus on healing, whoever you are. Focus on healing. Getting past this, okay. Getting past this first. All right. Till next time. Namaste for now.